Hi Libra, welcome back to Omkara Tarot. And yes, I'm still unsettled, but that doesn't stop us from doing our readings, right? So here's another love read for you. I hope you guys are doing well. And please remember, Libra, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you, leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Libra and send them the messages we need to hear the most for their love life now. Thank you. All right, Libra, let's start your reading. Welcome back, all my subscribers. Thank you. Thank you for being here again. And newbies, do join us. Subscribe to the channel. Become part of us. We welcome you in. So newbies, I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side will be for you. One side will be for your person. And in the center, I'm going to have your dialogue message cards, your mutual energies, etc. And for the duration of the reading, this will be person A for me, this will be person B for me. If this is your reading, you'll know immediately which side you resonate best with, right? Okay, alright. Okay, Libra, action for person A and action for person B. Bottom of my deck, I have the Ten of Swords in reverse. A big, big, big ending. At least that's how one, or maybe both of you are feeling that. I don't know. This is our overall energy. So from what I'm feeling, Libra, one person wants to return. They want to come back. They've had this epiphany. They've had this enlightenment. They don't want to stay stuck anymore. They do want either to return or they want their partner to return. Basically, they want to revive this connection once again. The other person, well, has accepted that it's over. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. There was no new beginning here. There was nothing stable being offered. So person B, I think, has their eyes set on their future, looking out to see what else is out there. So before I start your reading, Libra, let's start your dialogue message cards. Let's see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be, and then we begin your reading. So Libra and that person, spirit, they could say something to each other now. What would that be? Libra and that person. Libra and that person, spirit. One more. Okay, thank you. I'm going to take a few more, Libra, from another deck. And if any of you are looking for personal readings, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Libra and that person. One more, last one. Libra and that person. Thank you. All right, Libra. The first card here says, I realize that you did not make me feel bad about myself. I did that. No one else comes close to all the good things you've done for me. I may not be good enough for you. You seem to have high standards. I act like I don't care, but deep down, it affects me more than you'll ever know. You're not the only one that's scared. This connection scares me too. I'm sorry for the mind games I played. I know it was wrong. See, now somebody's had that epiphany that whatever I was doing was wrong. What did I do? Maybe they did it because they were insecure. They didn't feel good enough. I would be honored to have a family with you. All right, Libra, these were some of your messages. Let's start your reading. I'm going to start with an angel blessing card. Let's see what my angels have for you first, and we'll clarify these cards. So, my angels, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Libra. Blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Libra, please. Thank you. Okay, the card I have for you is safe travel. I think Aries got the same card as well. So yes, this is like a huge cycle, I think, Libra. This was like almost like a spiritual lesson, a karmic lesson. I don't know what you guys taught each other. Must have been really painful. But the good part is, after the ending always starts a brand new beginning, and the angels are supporting this transition from one phase of your life to another. put this card here, Libra, and let's start your reading now. Let's see what's going to happen. So person A, I'm going to just concentrate on this side, okay? Person A, and focus on them for the time being, then we'll move on to the other side. So why is the Eight of Cups in reverse? They want to talk. They want to come back and clear the air. They want to talk. They have healed quite a bit, I think, or they're just wishing and hoping for some kind of a return. And they're very clear-minded now. They know what they want. They know what they want to say, I guess. What they're very clear about is that person B is their star, their wish fulfillment, and they want to return back to person B. So why is the Hangman in reverse then, Spirit, for person A? Why do they feel this way? They've been thinking. This person had a little bit of pride and ego issues as well. Maybe they were blocked off to seeing the reality of this connection. But I think whoever the person A is has given it a lot of thought. They have been stressing like big time, maybe overthinking, thinking, whatever. But I have a feeling now they want to come out of this thinking mode. They want to get out of this stuck place. Heart of Hearts person A wants to transform this connection. Like I told you right at the beginning, Ten of Swords is like, a card of endings. But after an ending comes a brand new beginning. And that is what person A is wishing for. I want to transform this connection. I want to have victory once again. That's what they want. Okay. Now let's see what led to this kind of feeling. What happened, person A, in the recent past that suddenly now you've realized this? Two of Cups in reverse. They suddenly realized that person B was their soulmate. They fear losing. Yes, things have become very stagnant. I think both of you have been holding back from each other for some time. But they don't want to lose person B. They want to hold on to this connection. They know the choice. They know what their choice is. Certain things may have been revealed, maybe energetically or through spirit. Some things have become clear to this person that they have destroyed a soulmate connection. And what happened, Spirit, with the Page of Cups in reverse in the recent past? One more. Somebody lied that they wanted this, I think somebody was pretending all this while that they didn't want this love offer. They maybe stayed stuck for too long. They didn't make a decision. Maybe they were busy with work or chasing money or building up their finances. But now somebody is sure of their choice and they do want to work on it, it seems. Even though till now, I don't think they've made that love offer or even apologized for the way they behaved, but they are quite sure. They seem to be planning something. Let's see what that is. So person A, how do you feel about the connection now? Well, person A says, I allowed the tower to blast and fall. So then what are you going to do about it? Oh, person A says, I made some very unwise and foolish choices in my life. I know that I'm the cause of this disruption that's happened in our connection. Excuse the banging in the background. Like I said, I'm still moving home, so there's a little bit of woodwork going on the other side. Just bear with the noise, please. So person A feels whatever mind games I played, they've totally backfired on me now. I feel like I've become the loser in the game. I'm the one who destroyed it and thinking, I'll be the winner or in my pride and my ego or whatever. But now I've finally realized that everything that happened, I became the loser and my person is shining bright. They're looking at their person as gorgeous and abundant and fiery and attracting attention wherever they're going, and they are feeling totally stuck. Okay, so Queen of Wands, why do you see this person as the Queen of Wands person? A one more. they've now kind of realized that this Queen of Wands was their Two of Cups, the one that they lost. They suddenly figured out here, the same card was here as well, right? This is what happened in the recent past. They disregarded the soulmate connection for some reason. I don't know, each of you will have a different story. But they rejected this twin flame or soulmate or whatever they had. And now they've recognized, this is my person, this is my person. And now I've kind of created an imbalance. What else do you think about person B now, person A? How else do you see a person? They see their person as going off for a brand new beginning. They see their person really excited, fiery, passionate, moving on with stability into their own life. Now they want them back. Let's go on to the other side, Libra, and see what's happening here. Person B, why do you have the Ace of Pentacles in reverse? Person B says, I'm not really interested in having them back. Well, they can come back if they want, but I'm not going to deal with any drama from them. You know, I'm very confident about myself. I can handle it. If they do come back, maybe I can talk to them or whatever. But I've become very, very confident. I am the Queen of Wands. And that's exactly how person A was seeing them, right? As the Queen of Wands. The person B saying, well, even if they come back, I know they're going to create some drama. I don't want that. And there was one more card. I've lost it now. I don't know where it is. But yeah, basically this is what person B is saying. Yes, this was it. I'm not interested now. They never offered me this Ace of Pentacles when I was with them. And if they come back, I'm sure they're going to create drama again. I'm not even willing to, you know, expect it now. I'm not even expecting it, because if I don't expect it, I can avoid some more arguing, some more conflict with them. You know, Omkara Tarot, I'm already looking out to see what else is there. In fact, things have already started growing in my own little world. I'm not even looking at the past anymore. Three of Wands, yes, person B says, I don't have time for, you know, irrelevant conversations or messages. I don't expect it. I don't send it. If there's never going to be any commitment, if there's never going to be any future, why waste my time? You know how many other things I have to look forward to, how many new things that I have to work on. I am the Queen of Wands, and I'm not interested in talking to actually anyone who's not going to be stable and solid in my life. So what happened, person B? What happened in the recent past for you to have made such a strong decision? Person B says they lied to me. Ace of Swords in reverse. Person B says that I found out that they were a liar and they were keeping a lot of secrets. This is as straight as it can get. Lies and secrets. I think person B was expecting a partnership. They were expecting an equal give and take. But they never got that offer. Yeah, they felt rejected. They felt they were not given that offer that they were expecting. Maybe they were feeling they got breadcrumbed. Maybe that person was giving to more than one, whereas this Queen of Wands was expecting an equal give and take. So I think person B decided, I can't keep going round and round the merry-go-round with nothing is ever going to happen, so I'm going to shut it down. Okay, so I think person B decided to get off, yes, and they made it very clear as well. I think some communication happened as well where, well, it could have been discussed that, well, I'm dropping this. I don't want to be juggled anymore. I'm over and I'm out. I'm not going to do this again. So person B, how do you feel about the connection now? How do you feel about person A? Person A is very, very egoistic. They're very, very egoistic. I have stopped moving towards them. Absolutely, I'm guarding myself. I have my barriers up. Since I've put my barriers up, I'm feeling even more confident. I'm actually getting victory in my own life now. Being with them meant being in third parties. okay, and that meant having sleepless nights and trauma and not being able to, you know where this connection is going, always wondering whether they're going to come back or are they with somebody else. I've put a stop to all that. I'm guarding myself, and I'm not dealing with their pompous, you know, attitude or their ego or their pride. I've totally closed myself off. I'm not moving towards them at all. Blocked them. Chariot spirit versus chariot. Chariot. Yes, person B says, I have been healing for a very long time. I'm finally out now. I'm out of my, you know, retreat. I've done my healing and I'm ready to work on myself. Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. The minute I said that, I'm willing to have this creative, passionate new beginning. I'm working with others, with my work, on new love, work, life, everything. And I'm so excited, Omkara Taro, about this new path that I've, you know, gone to. And that's only happened after I shut this past person off. I feel free. I feel I can fly. Okay. So, let's see if you guys will take any action now, Libra. I'm going to take a different deck for this one, Libra. And of course, this is my time to request you all to hit that like button so that the videos can circulate a little more and reach more and more people. And of course, it makes me really happy as well. Thank you so much. And newbies, don't forget to hit that notification bell so that YouTube can notify you whenever new videos are uploaded. Person A's action is the Queen of Cups in reverse. Why is that? Why is that an action from person A's spirit? Okay, and then they are going through major heartbreak. Major heartbreak. Yes, they do want to come back. They do want to come back. But some, as much as they want to come back, if they had a choice, they would get on that chariot and come now, Libra. But somewhere they feel that this Queen of Cups will not allow them back in, which we saw. They feel they energetically, maybe they're feeling, or they've got to know, or maybe this Queen of Cups said something. They know that this Queen of Cups is got real huge boundaries now and will hold back from them. They're fearing that no love will be reciprocated to them now, and they're sitting here in huge heartbreak. This is very, very painful. This is like a person screaming in pain, because they feel they've lost the love of their person. So will you just sit here or will you take any action, person A? Not healthy to sit in heartbreak like that. Will you take any action? Will you even try? Person A? No, they're still sitting in a little bit of ego and pride. Their pride doesn't allow them to come forward because they feel person B is doing so well in their life. They don't love them anymore. They'll hold back. Okay, so person B, will you take any action? Two of Wands in reverse. Okay, so they're not standing around waiting anymore. They have chosen their own path or a path. Let's see what that is. What's the path you've chosen, person B? Two of Wands in reverse. What have you decided? Too many cards. One card, please. Two of Wands in reverse. Seven of Swords. And the World. Seven of Pentacles. Ace of Pentacles. Okay, person B, I think, waited around for a very long time, waiting for person A to say something, do something. But as we saw, they were scared and they were sitting in heartbreak, right? So I think person B has made up their mind. They've been very disappointed, waiting for so long for person A to make some move, that well, they're not telling anyone about it. Maybe they're not announcing it to person A, but they've decided to get out of this connection. They're slowly or quietly easing themselves away from this connection so they can go have a brand new beginning somewhere else. This Ace of Pentacles is everywhere. Ace of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles. And person B was complaining that I was never offered this Ace of Pentacles. I think person B has realized, not just one, I can make many more all by myself. And I'm going off for a brand new beginning, closing this old chapter and starting a brand new one. But I'm in control and not have to deal with anyone who lies to me, cheats on me. So I'm going to quietly take off for a brand new beginning. I think energetically, person A is feeling that. They're seeing person B having victory in their own life, feeling good about themselves. And also, they see them holding back from them, not showing any love to them. And they're sitting in complete heartbreak. So that's all I have for you, Libra. No wonder this was our overall energy of this reading. This is how person A is feeling, that it's unrevivable, if that's a word. Only because they're not taking action, because they're assuming and presuming. From what I feel, person B was waiting for some time till they're finally now giving up. So till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste, Libra.